Hello, welcome back. So I'll do the fight and then I'll show you the items I got and some of the other stuff I was doing off camera. I played for about 5 hours to get all of this, I don't know. So this is one of the artifact weapons you can get from the tomb. And as you can see, it has a lot of interesting stuff. I think there's some bug. I'll show you the spear after the fight because I'm sadly stuck in the fight. When I was fighting, instead of pressing load, I pressed save, and when I pressed saved, it saved my entire game on the save file I've been using for maybe 5 hours or more, and I can't do anything else about it. It saved without prompting me or without asking me. It didn't ask me this, so that's a stupid way to lose an entire save file, but hey, be careful with stuff like this because it really can mess up everything. Don't accidentally press save during a battle. So this is the Phantom Swarm for the quest. No, you know what, let's not use that just yet, let's run away. Let's take it a little slower this time. Yeah, the problem with this fight, the Swarm of Ludern, is that the Ghost Hunt of Ludern, is that you start in this weird arena where enemies can come from all directions. Which is not fair in many ways, because you will sometimes get attacked from the fog, and sometimes the nightmare will spawn on a different side of the map, or on the opposite side of the map, and that, believe me, is not fun. Not one bit of fun. So let's try and do this a little slower, a little more methodical. Right now I don't see any of the enemies and they cannot even reach me, probably. I don't know, this is just very weird. Usually the Phantom Swarm comes from only one direction, but if you play like this, you have no idea what's going to happen. I will assume they will come from the bridge. Just end the turn. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. I forgot about this. They just walk through your Overwatch like it's nothing, and it's very stupid and annoying. And I hate it. Okay, let's try and kill all of these guys, even though that means I'll probably have to step in poison when we get out. Okay, so now everyone is burning. Well, I had to try. And there is a lot of poison in the arena. In the battlefield. On the battlefield. Sentry Marcher is mostly useless when something like this happens. Oh, now you hit him. Okay. At least that's something. But I think I can kill the Grey Wolf at least. I can, but probably I can kill the boar. Almost can kill. Let's turn that almost into a kill. So sadly I cannot equip my heroes with anti-terror gear. Anti-terror gear, that sounds like they're equipping a special SWAT team for anti-terrorist. No, cannot equip them with anti-terror gear. Is it worth it? Yeah, more or less. Oh, Yeah, we can kill this guy, no problem. Okay, anything else I want to do right now? No, not really, except maybe put my archer over here where it's relatively safe. Yeah, nothing I can do about that. Now, I think I should probably just kill off all of the phantom or the ghost enemies I see. We'll have an easier time when the big guy comes along. I like his little spinny move. That's an interesting one. Well, I don't think I have a choice in this matter. Let's just put him over here to intercept everyone that comes from this direction. He can intercept the one that comes from that direction. And we only have two stacks of terror. One hero and one on the other. Yeah, this is what I'm afraid of, and this is what I don't like. Remember that Nightmare will generate terror almost each round if you're not careful. And he's also super far away. He also has too much strength to be critted by this guy, so... yeah. That felt like a very casual slap on the face. I don't know, at this point my best bet would have been to put the archer. I probably should have used the archer first, doesn't matter. Let's see what they do. There are 8 animals left, which is quite a lot of animals considering we barely have any valor points left. So let's recharge those. Now the good thing is one will not be fighting in the poison. I don't think the nightmare can reach us all the way over here, so let's do that. And if it reaches us over here, I want to have a clear battlefield. No interruptions. Yeah, let's not block anything. The mosquitoes are sucking the blood of the ghost animals. That's hilarious. Oh no, the nightmare will not be able to reach me. I think he will want to reach me. He will try it. I don't know. I have a very bad feeling about this. Like I said, I lost the first time I tried it because, I don't know, he spawned too far away for me to do anything. So, Mark of Narxes. So, I guess I have to be close to him and, I don't know, we'll just have to see. I have to be close in melee and then hit him again and that will consume it. I guess you basically get a free attack, I don't know. But that means I have to get a spearman. I probably will get a spearman. Now, is it worth going over? No, it's not worth. It's definitely not worth going over there by any mean of the... by any stretch of the imagination. Oh, hello. I wasn't expecting an attack from behind me. That was a good flank. Yeah. No, no, no. I thought the nightmare would scream every turn, unless they are different. Maybe the nightmares from the quest are different. Because this one will give you terror if you attack it. Terrifying presence. Yeah, now this makes things a lot more complicated and I don't like complicated things. I guess I can just do it like this. Since the boar didn't have enough to reach us, okay. Wait. Oh, it's that one. Well, I guess technically I should not allow the wolf to attack again, so let's... Oh, even better. So he has no terror and full armor. Well, I guess you can sit over here. I also don't have any more points, which is sad. Okay, let's see how this works. Will this cause an attack of opportunity? So that means a double attack? Let's see. We'll see next time. We will see that next time. And there are still... Oh, come on. Exactly what I wanted to prevent, I didn't prevent. Another one came from the darkness again. But we did get galvanization, which is great. Oh, what a weird fight. Okay, let's move everyone into position then. Let's move away from this area of death, decay and poison. The nightmare doesn't have much to do right now, I mean... Yeah, he throws his stuff at me and... That's the attack I was actually afraid of. Yeah, let's kill the last phantom boar. What? You can... This is interesting, I didn't know you can do it like this. Okay, Mr. Nightmare, you are free to go. Run away on the plains. I don't know if that changes much for the loot, I don't see any difference. You get the white, maybe you get less white leather, but it's usually, I got between 10 and 15, if I remember correctly. I don't know, okay. Yeah, if he wants to flee and fight another day, that's his choice, and or not. The hunt has begun, the hunt is over. Yeah, sorry about that, I had no way of doing that otherwise. So. Let's level them up. Movement. Sadly, yeah, well, I guess movement will be his strong point. He'll be able to move as far as I can see. Yeah. Usually you'll have to reroll for this, but I don't like to do that. It's scummy. I'll just leave it as it is. Remember, they can go up to level 8 in this patch. But it's actually pretty hard to reach that level. Okay, let's talk about the legendary weapons that you can find in the tomb, that you can craft using the lectern, of course. This one, the Narses Hunting Bow. And then the Horun Hunting Spear. It's weird because this one applies also the Mark of Narses. Nothing applies the Mark of Horun, so I don't understand how you're supposed to apply it. Narses. Mark of Horun apply, consumes the target, if not, applies the Mark of Narxes. I think the spear should apply the Mark of Horun, I don't know. Maybe I'm not understanding it, but as you can see, they're super, super strong ones. It's a basic attack, but still, with that amount of stat bonuses, you will end up always dealing too much damage anyway, so it's even better than skills. And the other thing I found from the precious items were the military medal and that other one. Smooth tablet, otherwise I don't think this will give me something interesting. But there's something really wrong with the save system, as you can see. Yeah, let's delete that one. It shouldn't work like that, so why was the ghost swarm so far away from that location, I don't know. Let's go over there and I'll show you where it begins. Maybe I didn't understand it the first time. But it's very hard to track the blood stains through the swamp, of course. What do you guys have? You have any armor for me? Yeah, you have repair tools. I had a very bad time getting all of the food I needed to wait for about 20 days or something like that to craft all of that stuff. And we have a couple of rat nests, and we also have the boss. I'm not sure if I can defeat the boss or not. I'll have to give it another go. Maybe after I reach level 8 with everyone, that would be a choice. So let's see how far away it truly is from the spot where you should start. Because by the time you get to that spot, you'll have more chances of getting another phantom swarm in these woods over here. One spawns over there. So once I killed one of the phantom swarms over there, and of course it was not the right one. Anyway, it's a little peace. It's a peaceful location. I also had to spend basically a lot of knowledge points so I can get all of the cooking recipes for the mutton and the braised chicken. Otherwise, you'll not have enough food in this region. I kind of like the idea that you will not have enough food in certain regions, but I think they should make it another way. Okay, so the body is over here, I forgot where it is. Let me see if I still have the... Yeah, the Ludern Hand. Ludern... Ratclaw Cave and your Ludern Gel. The body should be over here, and then let's see how far you have to go. Oh man, I'm traveling so fast. If I ever replay the game from zero, it will be such a different thing to play with slower speed, I don't know, lower equipment quality and other stuff. Don't interrupt me, I'm actually browsing stuff. Venison, that's great, I can cook this and get more food, of course. Said I don't have... whatever. No, I'm actually being chased in the wrong direction. I have to come all the way down there to the tower over here. Then go... let's pay the wages first. And then we'll do the reset of the skills, because that's something I also never did on camera. Never did while I was recording. Was it this way? Is it really that far? Yeah, it is. Okay. Also, keep in mind, this place doesn't have a market. So if you want food, you'll have to go to the tavern and buy the infused wolf ribs, if they have them or not. Otherwise, you'll just have to steal your food. Which is, again, it's kind of an interesting mechanic. I hope they develop it more. Why not? As long as we're here, we can steal it. So maybe in other regions you'll be so pressed for food that you'll have to steal stuff. I don't know. On the other hand, you can just buy more food from other regions where there's plenty of it available. I don't know. I would like to see this mechanic expanded a lot more. What did I go the other way again? Anyway, doesn't matter. The thing is that it's very, very far away. From where we started to where we had to go. Okay, so over here is a companion camp, so we have to turn around. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to reset the skill of my archer. I accidentally... Well, not accidentally, I thought it would be more useful to have, you know, animal companions, but apparently they are useless because they... count against you in the number game, and the enemy will have one more enemy on their side as well. So yeah, I need to replace the beast memory with precision. Doesn't really say if it counts barrage attacks, because if that counts the barrage attacks, that means you'll apply weakness very easy, or vulnerability very easy. Actually, I think it will be better to get this one. Taming arrow, that's funny. Lose damage to apply damage, yeah. Reload the front actually is interesting. Or the passive skill of an allied animal, I don't know. Seems like... I assume it doesn't mean the donkeys as well. Usually if you inflict a critical hit to this bow, the target will die. I guess bleeding is the best option since vulnerability. You'll probably have a very high crit chance by the time you... No, what I... Oh, come on, this is so annoying. Theft. Okay, let's just pay. This is another thing they have to fix. I mean, how... You're stuck. You have no way of telling if that's a dead end. It looks normal to me. Yeah, I think the developers are way in over their heads with this game. They have so much to fix and so much to balance and so much to add. Also, keep in mind, they're releasing another game. So is she. Shiro Game is releasing another game. I think they'll come and attack me again. Man, I cannot believe it how hard some regions are compared with the other ones, especially... It's not hard in the sense of you'll lose the game, it's hard because you lose a lot of time. Yeah, let's eat. We should have eaten the big meal, so they didn't have any clues. Oh, and that's another Glasslands. Well, probably all of them were like that. I think this is 100 gold each, so yeah. Not such a big deal. Also, you know what is a big deal? A big deal is to getting your scholar up to this level, because the willpower is not important, but restoring a legendary treasure grants one knowledge point. So that means you'll find a lot more ancient treasure. Let's read that again. Restoring a legendary treasure. So far we have two legendary treasures, which are the weapons. The spear and the bow. Doesn't specify if there will be a unique armor or a legendary treasure as an armor or stuff like that, so... Yeah, there might be a lot more than we think. Did I want to complete the quest? Oops, I forgot to go over there and do that. Well, I guess we'll go back over there and then we'll speak more about the game. 353. I think I bought all of the recipes from this guy. Yeah. I have to go there and turn in the quest, sorry about that. I was not thinking, I was upset at the weird turn of events, I don't know. I'll definitely have to play more on the save file, because we have a lot more things to do. But we're done with the swamp, we just have to kill the rat nest, which I don't really want to do, because if you want to kill the rat nest, you have to get a lot of resources out of it. If you want to get a lot of resources out of it, you will have to do... You'll have to play it a very, very cautious game. So let's save before we do anything, because I don't want to lose my save game again, my save file again. We have the barber kits, the beast taming. I didn't notice we have a beast taming strategy. Skill mastery books are over here. This specialization is the one we want, but why do we have beast taming? I don't remember this one. So, remember, perspective. Well, to be honest, I think at this point it will just be better to have the perspective. I forget where I got this book, because 20% damage skill, considering we dealt so much damage, will be a pretty big increase in our damage, of course. So yeah, I'll probably play with this one, since I don't do a lot of flanking or a lot of opportunist attacks. As for her, she's a thief, of course. As for her critical chance, it's 35. I don't think I'll need more than that. Also, she had a bloodthirsty perk, so I don't know. If you really want to mid-max everything, you'll have to probably... restart the game until we get the bloodthirsty one, because it's an extra 3% critical hit. The other ones, what are the other ones? Nimble, 5% more stat dexterity. Well, it's important, but he was not a dexterity character. What do you have? Solitary? Oh, so I guess that's one of the things. Okay, so you will want your duelist or your cutthroat have destroyed 10% more damage if not next to an ally. And with the duelist and of course the 360 degree at the circle hit of the dagger. Okay, that makes sense. Hardworking. This is definitely not what you want. Hardworking is the worst trait I have on someone. Okay, he loves studying combat tactics, whatever, specialization 500, that's actually a lot. So how does that work right now? I guess... Why is she naked? Oh, because she cannot equip the light armor, so it's a full rest specialization. Kills an enemy, you gain one valor point, yes. I guess you can also go with the hunter one. But the barrage is just too much, it's too good. Slowdown. This one is pretty good as well, but you saw how... No, you... That's just too good to pass away. Precision, every two attacks. I mean, every three attacks will deal... I mean, it's basic knowledge, it's mathematics, it's statistics, it's analytics. Every free attacks, although critical hit no matter what, so why should I pick this one? For an extra chance to get another critical... Yeah, you might get two critical hits in free attacks, but there's no guarantee. So, reinforced arrows it will be. And that's about it, you cannot change the... You cannot respec everything, as you can see, selecting other trade points to min-max everything. That's kind of like the only thing you can choose. So basically, you respec to make 3 choices or 4 choices later if you are maxed level for this patch, which is 8. It's not so bad, it's not so good, I don't know. I guess if you want to use another character or use another subclass, yeah, let's go and do the... Oh, it's so far away. And I'll probably have to do another video where, like I said, I'll defeat the boss. I'm not sure if I want to reach level 8, because it's so boring at this point. Look at how much experience they need to reach level 8. Okay, let's complete the quest and I want to see the reward and then I'll end the video. It was very fun. It's a very fun game. I almost feel like it's not enough content for the price. Even now it's not enough content for the price. I hear people are playing for what? 100 hours? I think I have 100 hours as well. Playing for 100 hours, crafting for 20 hours, I don't know. Having 10 people in the... Oh, having 10 people would be a nightmare in this game. 10 mercenaries. It's the skills for the two-handed sword are very, very bad. Oh, it's a level 7 one. So it's a medium armor. Okay, let me show you. 76, 17, 4. Let's see how it does with the... medium armor. Why is your armor so bad? Because it's level 4. Oh no, did I... probably should have bought him a better armor a long time ago. But I guess I kept forgetting about it, so as you can see, the armor is much, much better, 76. Yeah, I do lose one movement point, but does it matter? Not really. Critical hit is 5. What? Does it matter? Does it really matter? No, it doesn't matter. Now he's a proper tank. Yeah, don't get caught up on the stats or trying to mid-max. Like I said, everything will change so fast and so often, you'll not even have time to think about it. Here, take that. Wow, 84 and 17. 22, I think. Look at what I was using before, 12 strength, 22 strength. Yeah. I guess I'll get level 7 gear right now. I'm not sure if we'll get level 8 gear. I think the game, don't quote me on this, I think the game is capped at level 7 for gear and level 8 for units, but you rarely see level 8 units, maybe never. Level 7 is not so hard to see. But I'm still finding level 4 and 5 enemies, like the ones from the quest. No, it would be so funny if... Imagine you attack the quest enemies while they're fighting the mosquitoes, so you join the mosquitoes against the quest enemies. Okay, let's run away. Okay, so here, I messed up the location as well, so you had to come from the Ludern Gel all the way across the bridge over here. That's such a long way. That's the correct route. I can't believe it, they're so far away from the original one. Okay, no more Remedy Imperfect, you will get the good medicine. And I also want to make sure I buy everything from the camp over here. Every recipe I can buy with the... What are they? Thief? Thanks. Huh? I forgot where the camp is. I think it's above here. Yeah, here it is. The small trucker camp. Oh, that's a weird graphical glitch. It's not an outline, it's... Oh. Never mind, doesn't matter. So they have Seruna back. I don't see where she is. I think we got her back and then she left or something. This also should be changed a little. I mean, if in case you don't have money, you can buy with fangs, but that's still way too expensive considering how hard it is to get fangs. Did the swarm seem different this time? Yes! It seemed more aggressive. Reinforced Lair of the Ox. Lair of the Ox. I guess this is how you get the Ox. The Ox gives you Guard. It's a really interesting system, but as you saw, it's not even that important. Because you can buy better stuff than you can craft, and besides, you might be able to get better stuff by crafting, but that's basically 20 hours of grinding, and it's not worth it. So the Ox gives you Guard, Rat, critical hit and movement, Ox is only movement, Falcon is dexterity and critical hit, this is probably the one you'll want. Stag is armor and strength, it's actually quite good. We have one more lair to get. I don't know what that is. Yeah, I'll have to come and revisit every region and buy a lot of stuff. I don't know. A lot of busy work for me. See you next time. Bye.